Hello, beautiful people of the internet. What's up? It's your girl, Lakisha. With spring just around the corner, it's the perfect time to prepare your skincare routine for the new season, as your skin's needs may change. In today's video, I've partnered with Aprilskin to show you how to switch up your skincare routine for spring. If this is your first time seeing my face, my name is Lakisha, and on the channel, I post a lot of skincare, lifestyle, makeup, and hair-related videos. If that is something you're interested in, then make sure you are subscribed. And without further ado, let's get started. In my household, spring has always been the time to declutter and clear out items that no longer serve you. The same applies with your skincare collection. Take inventory of your products. Check for expiry dates. Check for anything that smells funny or is separating a little bit. You don't want to be using expired skincare on your face. If you have a product that you no longer use or maybe didn't work for your skin type, consider repurposing them. A vitamin C serum that was too strong for your face may be the perfect addition to your body skincare routine to get rid of dark spots, or consider giving it to a friend or a family member. It also helps to keep a running list of all the products you've been using throughout the year. That will make this process a lot easier. There's tons of skincare apps to choose from, a simple note-taking app on your phone, or like me, you can use a bullet journal. I use this to track all of my products, my skincare routines, as well as my lifestyle habits to ensure that I stay on track with my skincare goals. Seasonal allergies are synonymous with the spring season. During this time, you may find your skin is a little bit more irritable than normal. You may experience more redness or even dullness to the skin. When dealing with irritable skin, there are two changes that you need to make to your routine: using gentler products, as well as simplifying your routine in general. Aprilskin's calendula collection features the marigold flower, which has been used for centuries for its medicinal properties. It's been known to help heal and soothe the skin. It's an antioxidant. It has antibacterial and anti-inflammatory properties, making it helpful at treating acne-prone skin. If you want to get your hands on any of Aprilskin's calendula collection, I will leave a link down below for you guys to get a taste of it yourself. You will still need to remove the dullness from the winter season, so switching to gentler forms of exfoliation like enzymes, PHAs, and even gentler forms of AHAs will ensure that you're not further irritating your skin, especially around the nose and mouth. If I'm not wearing any makeup, sometimes I skip a double cleanse altogether, or at the very least, I'll use micellar water. Tonight, I'm going in with my calendula low pH foam cleanser. It has a thick jelly texture with little calendula petals, so it's really beautiful to look at. It emulsifies into an airy, foamy texture, and it's pH balanced at 5.5, so it's not gonna leave your skin feeling stripped or tight. What's unique about this cleanser is that it has micromicellar bubbles. This binds to oil residue on the face, so even without a double cleanse, this is perfect at removing SPF from your skin. It will also be slightly exfoliating because it does contain salicylic acid as well as willow bark. However, it is gentle enough to be used on a daily basis. You guys know I enjoy either a fragrant-free or very muted scent to my products. Now this does have a slight citrus or lavender scent because of the extracts, however I don't find it irritating or overpowering whatsoever. If you're using this in the morning, you'll want to make sure to apply SPF. Like me, if you are trying to fade hyperpigmentation, you'll want to use some sort of cellular peel 1 to 2 times a week after cleansing. I'm going straight in with Aprilskin's Calendula PHA Hyaluronic Peeling Gel. Its main ingredients are calendula, papaya enzyme, 0.3% PHA, and hyaluronic acid, so it's very hydrating for the skin. You'll want to apply this gel on dry skin. It has a very soft, custard-like texture. The ingredient balls up as you rub it in, forming clumps that cling to dead skin cells and flakes on the surface of the skin. You're basically rolling them off of your face. Winter season is all about lipids and moisture, but spring is all about that hydration. Hydration plumps the skin, giving you good texture. It allows the skin to heal itself, as well as reduces inflammation. Now, of course, this includes drinking more water, but it also means adding more humectants to your skincare routine. Here are some of the ways that I like to increase hydration in my skincare routine. Try layering a moisturizing toner 3 to 7 times in place of a serum. I did a video on this in my I Moisturize with Water only for a week, and I found it really helped to make my skin plump and feel very hydrated. Here on YouTube, the Golden Prescription also has the maximum hydration method, which involves layering your toner between every step of your skincare routine. When you think of hydration, often exfoliation doesn't come to mind. But exfoliants, or specifically chemical exfoliants, can be very helpful at adding hydration to the skin, as well as prepping the skin to absorb even more moisture. Now, you don't want to go overboard, because the last thing you want to do is over exfoliate the skin. This is the Calendula 10% PHA AHA Resurfacing Serum. It has a lightweight consistency, very watery, almost like a toner. It absorbs quickly into the skin and you don't need a lot of it to be effective. It cleans out the pores, decongests the skin, and helps even out the skin tone, giving you a more radiant complexion. This is a leave-on treatment that will help reduce the appearance of your blemishes over time. I love that the powerhouse of this serum is the polyhydroxy acid, because PHAs are the gentlest forms of chemical exfoliants, so this is not going to be irritating to your skin whatsoever. Now, it does have a light scent of bergamot and citrus, but it has a ton of humectants that are going to help to soothe the skin, like glycerin, propionyl, I hope I'm pronouncing that properly, butylene glycol, as well as panthenol. To brighten the skin, you'll want to make use of more vitamin C if you can, both internally and externally. But strong forms of vitamin C can be very harsh and irritating to the skin, especially during allergy season. So opt for gentler ingredients like niacinamide or azelaic acid that are both anti-inflammatory agents, and they play well with just about everything. They both help to control oil production and help to fade post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation. In terms of retinol, you can continue using it if you've been using it already, but this is definitely not the time to start a new retinol. Dial it back just a bit when it comes to moisturizer. Look for lightweight, creamy, gel-like textures or water bombs. These will be your best friend this season. And even better, get a lightweight moisturizing SPF to just limit the amount of products that you're using on your face. Just make sure that you're applying enough to get adequate sun protection. For my moisturizer, I'm going in with Aprilskin's Artemisia Squalane Hydrogel Cream. It's made of 80% Artemisia water, basically mugwort, another slept-on ingredient that helps calm the skin, gets rid of redness. It actually has both vitamin A and vitamin C already in it, which both renews and brightens the skin. Then we have 3% squalane, a wonderful lightweight oil for acne-prone skin that won't clog your pores. This hydrogel cream is completely weightless. It gives a cooling feeling to the skin because of its gel-like texture. It absorbs quickly and leaves a balance or a suppleness to the skin without leaving you feeling greasy or sticky. You can use this moisturizer both morning and night, and of course follow up with a good SPF. During this allergy-infested season, the eyes tend to be very itchy or red or dry and irritated, and of course allergy medication will help. I just restocked mine, but using depuffing or cooling tools and products can be very helpful as well. For depuffing, you can use hydrogel eye patches or even green tea bags as a cooling compress on your eyes. You could also use jade rollers or gua sha tools to help to drain the liquids in the face. I like doing facial massages with my fingers, and if you concentrate on the eye area and the nose area, it can help to release any tension in the face as well as reduce nasal congestion. This is really helpful for me because you guys don't know, but I have a lot of congestion and I edit it out of my videos. To help with dryness, you can use a thin layer of moisturizer as an eye cream, or even straight up Vaseline works very well for protecting your eyelids. Just make sure that you are keeping it far enough away from your eyes, as the heat from your body will help to melt the product anyways, and all by itself it will just get closer to your eyes, so keep it down here. And a big thank you once again to Aprilskin for collaborating with me on this video. My skin has been glowing, and it just goes to show that gentle skincare works. I hope you guys enjoyed this video as much as I loved making it and learned a little bit about Aprilskin. Comment down below and let me know what are your favorite tips and tricks for changing up your skincare routine for spring. I would love to know. Make sure to click over here to see some of my previous videos. Remember to stay gorgeous, fabulous, because I will see you lovely ladies and gents in my next video. Bye!